7 that was supposed to be brought through the firstborn nation, that is Israel. Now I'm coming to the heart of the matter. Jesus at the temple. That is the subtitle in caption. Jesus at the temple. Verse 25. Now there was a man in Jerusalem called Simeon, who was righteous and devout. He was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. That's amazing to me. He has come through Bethlehem to be called firstborn, to be firstborn, right? To fulfill it. Then he must be taken where? To the temple. But when he's taken to the temple, he says, now there was a man there called Simeon. And he says, who was righteous and devout. I want to introduce you to this, step by step. And he says, he was waiting for the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit was upon him. Now look at this now. He says, this Simeon man that is now talking about here, when Jesus is being presented at the temple, you see the way they presented, and then the priest check if it's a firstborn male without defect. Remember, the way he's being presented. Now he says, there's a man called Simeon who was righteous and devout. And about this man, Simeon, he says that he was waiting for the consolation of Israel. That is the prophetic name of the Messiah. The consolation of Israel. Why? Because if you go, later we're going to see that. If you go to the book of John, the comforter, the consolation, consoler. If you go now to the book of Isaiah 40, verses 1 to 3, he said, comfort ye, Jerusalem. Speak tenderly to my people. Prepare ye the way he's coming. So he's the comforter. Do you understand this prophetic name? He was waiting for the consolation of Israel. And he says that this Simeon in Luke, before Acts, before the Pentecost, the Holy Spirit was already on him. He's righteous, he is devout, and he was waiting for the consolation, for the Messiah to come, and the Holy Spirit was upon him, had fallen on him, before the Pentecost. Can you imagine? Step by step, make sure this is now the center, the core of the message, this one here. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not die before he had seen the Lord's Christ. So now look at that. The Holy Spirit, there's this man. Now Jesus has been presented at the temple, but there is this man called Simeon. And this man now, the Bible tells us, is a righteous man and a devout man. And it says about this man that the Holy Spirit had revealed to him that, look, the consolation of Israel is coming. The Messiah is coming. And he had promised him, the Holy Spirit had promised him, you will not die until you first see the Messiah. That's very powerful. Get that, right? This Simeon is going to be a very important figure here. And I'm going to talk about the gospel he preaches the present church. Moved by the Spirit, meaning compelled by the Holy Spirit. You understand? Meaning he was totally under the influence of the Holy Spirit. Did you understand? He said, moved by the Holy Spirit. Look at that now. Moved by the Holy Spirit, he went into the temple courts. When the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what the custom of the law required, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, Sovereign Lord, as you have promised, you now dismiss your servant in peace. Step by step. Jesus being brought, now Simeon appeared. There is a Simeon who was actually righteous, devout, and was waiting for the consolation of Israel. The Holy Spirit had revealed to him that the Messiah is coming. And in the process, the Holy Spirit was upon him. Then when the child was being brought, he's compelled. He's moved by the Spirit to run there. And he says, goes to the temple courts. And then when he sees the child, look at what he does. He holds the child in his arm and says, Sovereign Lord, now you dismiss your servant in peace. Why? Because of this. Look at what it says there. Because for my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the sight of all people. And he goes on to say, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for the glory for your people Israel. Do you see the utterances of Simeon? The child's father and mother were marveled at what was said about him. Then Simeon blessed them and said to Mary, his mother, this child is destined to cause the falling and rising of many in Israel and to be a sign that will be spoken against, so that the thoughts of many hearts will be revealed, and a sword will pierce your own soul too. And then he says, there was also a prophetess Anna, the daughter of Phanuel, of the tribe of Asher. She was very old. She had lived with her husband for 7 years after her marriage, and then was widowed until she was 84. She never left the temple, but worshipped night and day, fasting and praying. Coming up to them at that very moment, she gave thanks to God and spoke about the child to all who were looking forward to the redemption of Jerusalem. I want to focus on this domain right now. This is big now. There is something very interesting that happens here. When it's time to present Jesus to the temple, now the Lord brings forth Simeon. Why wasn't he taken to Ashdod? All these places of Israel. Why? But was taken to Jerusalem. Because Jerusalem was the center of worship. People used to come all the way from Jericho, where, they used to come to Jerusalem for worship. Jerusalem was the center. In fact, it was both political, as you see now. Political and religious and worship center. But I want to focus on what's the worship center. That's why he was taken there. Number two, God sent Simeon as a special witness. We are beginning now to touch on Simeon bit by bit. Why? Because the Lord told him, you will not die. First of all, not the following. The Messiah is coming. He already knew, the Holy Spirit revealed to him that the Messiah is coming. And he told him, however, you will not die until you see, witness, the coming of the consolation of Israel, the Messiah. Simeon in Hebrew, I went to the Greek, I went to the Hebrew. I wanted, who is this Simeon? Before the Holy Spirit comes, he receives the Holy Spirit. This shocked me. I found out that Simeon actually means hearing. Which to me was very interesting to share with you, right? It means hearing. No wonder you heard from the Holy Spirit, right? Simeon was watching and waiting for the Messiah. Those are two things. When it's time to present Jesus, all of a sudden there is a Simeon, somebody. And the Holy Spirit says he is righteous and devout. And you can see because of those two qualities, the Holy Spirit is upon him. He's a vessel for the Holy Spirit. Do you understand? And he says, because he has the Holy Spirit had revealed to him the Messiah is coming, you must see, you must witness before you go. Right? And now he says, Simeon was watching and waiting. What does that mean? And we see that in the manner of talking here, Simeon was very, very, very old. Look at this now. That time, the Messiah had not come to the earth. So you can imagine the darkness that was on the earth. Jesus was not on the earth at that time. That's a very important point. I want you to understand the circumstances under which Simeon was righteous and devout. Circumstances under which the Holy Spirit picked him. The Messiah was not on the earth. Can you imagine the earth without Messiah? You cannot. I have seen the earth without the Messiah after the rapture. And in fact, in that mighty dream, just darkness came and covered the whole earth. And then I asked the Lord, I went down on my knees when I woke up, asked him, Lord, why was it dark when the church went away with the Messiah? He did not answer me then, but later he revealed to me that because the church is the light, and the Messiah's presence is the light, with the Holy Spirit that fuels it, the lamp, the light. When you take away that church, that's the vessel of that oil, burning light that you have, light, then darkness. Hallelujah. But listen to this. Simeon, when there was no Messiah on the earth, darkness is here. Then look at this now. Simeon is already watching and waiting. Could it be that we too as a church, we are right now at the same place where Simeon was? Hey, that's food for thought, right? look at this, look at the point here. The point is this. In that condition, when the Messiah is coming to be abused through the Bethlehem manger, meek and weak Messiah suffering to suffer, to be abused, Simeon waited faithfully. Simeon was righteous and devout, and then was watching and waiting for many years. He went to the temple every day. Look, 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 everybody, look. You can imagine, every day he went to the temple, and when the women brought on every day, when they brought the babies on every day, he was like this. Oh, no, not that one. Oh, no, not that one. Not that one. You can imagine, for years. Can you imagine? How about the church? Right now, he's coming, and the Bible says, and the Lord will come down. 1 Thessalonians 4:16-17. It says, and the Lord will come down, the Lord himself will come down with a loud command, trumpet of God, voice of God, triumph. Those are the signs of a victorious king coming. He's not coming to be abused the way Simeon waited for the one coming to be abused. If Simeon can wait for the Messiah who is coming to be abused so badly, how much more the church that is now waiting for the triumphant king, the king of glory, the victorious king with the trumpet of God, a blast of God, coming as a king of victory. How much should the church be waiting more than Simeon? How much more should the church be watching and waiting? Then the question becomes, why have we stopped watching and waiting? The present day church sometimes has stopped. How come this generation, waiting for the Messiah coming as a glorious king, cannot be watching and waiting like this? Oh no, not this one. So how many women have brought? Five, eh? Oh, not yet. How much more should we be waiting for the Messiah? What is wrong with the present church? Where are the Simeons of today? Because the Bible tells me, at that time the Messiah had not come. There was darkness on the earth. And he was coming to be abused. But the Bible says that Simeon was righteous and devout, a righteous man. And that reminds me of Noah. And he's saying that he was righteous and devout, meaning committed, unwavering faithfulness. And out of that the Lord found a vessel. We are also finding ourselves waiting for him, but coming as a glorious, victorious king. Where are the righteous and devout people? Where are the people that the Lord will reveal secrets about his coming? Where are the Simeons of today? Why has this church not waited? And they are not devout. Will the Lord find a faithful, devout man? The Holy Spirit is looking for a vessel. For us now, we should have been watching and waiting a higher plane, a higher level, a higher notch, a higher altitude. Why? Because now he's not coming to be abused, but he's coming as the king of victory with big pomp and color. Trumpet call, the shout of God, tremendous splash of glory. He's coming with power as a triumphant king. How much more should we be waiting? Hallelujah. Can I move on now? Matthew 24:42. Can I read that? Matthew 24:42. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know on what day your Lord will come. Do you understand what the church ought to be doing now? So each one of these, when you look at this component of firstbornhood, there is so much instruction to the church. And then another scripture is Matthew 25:13. Let me read it and see what it says. Therefore, keep watch, because you do not know the day or the hour. Mark 13:35. Revelation 16:15. Behold, I come like a thief. Blessed is he who stays awake and keeps his clothes with him, so that he may not go naked and be shamefully exposed. That means you remove your clothes to go sleep, found naked, right? Every day Simeon went there when it's time for the women to bring their firstborns. And you know he was very old now because of the way he speaks. Because when he sees the Messiah, he says, now your servant can go. Meaning he waited so far, right? But he said, oh, can you tell that, Mama? There you go. You understand? That is what he means by blessed are those who stay awake and keep their clothes on. Meaning constantly on the watch. Watching and waiting. Is the church doing this? We're beginning to see a message Simeon is beginning to pick the church. But first of all, let's go to this. Who is Simeon? The Bible says Simeon was a righteous man. Number two, we're just looking at the character of the person before the message. Number B means Simeon had a right standing with God. Number three, walked in God's command, kept God's covenant. Kept God's covenant. Can we move on? Was blameless. Was being in accordance with high moral standards. Being in accordance with high moral standards. Being in accordance with high moral standards. A man of integrity. A man of virtue. Meaning a virtuous man. A man of uprightness. A principled man. Meaning, regardless of what happens around me, for me, I'll always go in this direction. A principled man. Meaning, regardless of what's happening around me, for me, I've chosen to go this way. I'm principled. I've stood on this principle. But where are the principled people today? Another point, he was faithful. That's why he was able to wait that long. And because of that faithfulness, you see that the Lord now endowed him, deposited in him that treasure, that secret, that why he's coming. You will see him. And also the secret of saying, the treasure of saying, you will be the special witness. You're the one who will see him. Have we waited in the temple? You know the temple is a place of worship. Have we waited in worship? He eagerly expected to see the Messiah. The key word there is eagerly. Eagerly. Is there anybody in the present day church that is eagerly expecting to see the Messiah? Because I said, he went like this. Can you tell that mother to come forward a little bit? He walked like this for that day. So you can imagine. He eagerly expected to see the Messiah. Ah, what a place to be. Is the church eagerly expecting to see the Messiah? Simeon sees that he waits for so long. And when the Messiah is revealed, he takes the Messiah like this. When he takes the Messiah in his arm like this. Listen to what he says. Sovereign Lord! Sovereign Lord! Now my eyes have seen your promise. You can now dismiss your servant in peace. He said, Sovereign Lord, as you promised. Remember the promise of the Holy Spirit? You see that? You now dismiss your servant in peace. Look at this now. Simeon is speaking to the church. As you promised. Meaning, whenever the Holy Spirit promises, he must always fulfill it. That's the message of the church. And he's asking today's church, how about you? Why are you acting as though the Holy Spirit is a liar? This present church is acting as though the Holy Spirit is Mwongo. And yet the Holy Spirit promised that the Messiah is coming back. You say the Messiah is coming back. Why are you breaking heart and say, whatever, as though the Holy Spirit is lying? It's an indictment to the present day church. He's asking, are you also having the same Holy Spirit? But this Holy Spirit, what he told me, I told him, sovereign Lord, as you promised, it has been fulfilled now. Meaning the Holy Spirit, when he promises, must always be what? Fulfilled. Number two, Simeon, by holding the baby, sovereign Lord, as you promised, my eyes have now seen your promise. You can now dismiss your servant in peace. Look at this. Simeon, when he holds the Messiah, then he tells God, now it's okay, I can go now. Meaning, Simeon is saying this, for those who behold the Messiah, and I know you know who it is, the church, for those that behold the Messiah, and salvation, his salvation, your salvation, his salvation is in their view, like this they can see. Huh? He says, how ravished is the world around them. How useless is the world. Huh? He says, for those that behold this salvation, this Messiah, and his salvation, your salvation, is in their sight, rather in their view, close view. He's saying, how useless, how collapsed is the world around them. Because Simeon never says, now that I've seen the promise, allow me go say bye-bye to my people. He never says that. He says, now I can die, I can go. Meaning, there is no greater treasure than this. Did you understand? That for those who behold the salvation of this Messiah, they behold the greatest treasure in heaven and on earth. And everything else about the earth collapses. Simeon is saying, when you behold the Messiah, and his salvation, your salvation, is in your view, the world around you collapses. He did not say, Lord, release me to go say bye-bye to my firstborn. He said, now I can die. He said, now I can go. In what? In peace. Meaning, how beautiful is the death of a righteous person. Did you understand the message? Did you understand the message of all this? He's saying, how beautiful, how peaceful is the death of a righteous person. Meaning, Simeon is asking, why does this present day church cry so much? Why are they crying? Why are they fearing death like that? Could it be that these people are not righteous? He's saying, for me now that I've seen his salvation and I behold it, as the church does, now I also accept death in peace. Meaning, how peaceful is the death of a righteous man? How peaceful is the death of a righteous person? Meaning, for those who welcome the Messiah, like you welcome the Messiah. Listen, for those to whom the Messiah and God's salvation has been revealed to, like Simeon, revealed to, holding him, now they can also welcome death. Did you understand? That is the message Simeon is asking the church. How come you, church, you cry too much? You fear death too much? Simeon is asking, could it be true that the reason this church cries so much, everybody in your neighborhood will know that you are sick. You are crying, all your mother, your sisters, everybody, you are crying. Why does this church fear death? Could it be that this church is not righteous? Did you understand the indictment Simeon brings to the church? And that's why I have preached for many years saying that it is always good to be ready, to be righteous and holy. That if you die before the rapture, it is still okay. Or if the rapture comes before you die, it is still alright. Did you understand? Simeon is saying, for those who behold the salvation of this Messiah in their hands, having received the Holy Spirit there too, for his purpose, he's saying, then there is no more fear of death, because when Simeon beheld him, Simeon received a revelation that this Messiah has crushed death. Did you understand now? Because Simeon said, now release your servant in peace. Meaning, now I go in peace. He said, it's okay. If you die and you're righteous, it's okay. It is glory to the Lord. A righteous person has come. If the rapture happens before you die, it's okay. Did you understand people? Oh yes, it's not even a joke. How come for you, you are the beholders of this salvation like Simeon did in your hands, and you still value the world? He's saying that for those who behold the salvation of this Messiah, the world is poorer. The world is rubbished. The world is trashed. The world has collapsed. The world has no value. And that's why Simeon is asking, how come the church of this hour still values the world at the same time they're holding the salvation of Jehovah? This son, this Messiah, this firstborn, is destined to cause the falling and rising of men in Israel and by extension the earth, right? But listen, could it be that Simeon was saying that he has seen Jeremiah chapter 8 verses 4 to 12? Say to them, this is what the Lord says, when men fall down, do they not get up? All the way down. Could it be that Simeon saw the people that would reject this Messiah? Who are those people? Look at this now. Who are they? They are the people that will say, tell us, by whose authority are you doing these things? And they are busy worshipping there as he's being revealed out here. Tell us, by whose authority are you doing these things? Romans chapter 9 verse 33. He says, as it is written, see, I lay in Zion a stone that causes men to stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. And the one who trusts in him will never be put to shame. Matthew chapter 10, 26. So do not be afraid of them. There is nothing concealed that will not be disclosed, or hidden that will not be made known. If you look at the deeper meaning of revealed, really, in that Greek, it says the revealing of hidden things in the light. In the light. Do you understand what he said here now? That there is nothing that is hidden or concealed that will on that day not be revealed. And he says here, the judgment seat of the Messiah, Romans chapter 2 verse 16. What Simeon meant by the thoughts of many will be revealed, the hidden thoughts. He said, this will take place on the day when God will judge men's secrets through Jesus Christ, as my gospel declares. Acts chapter 17 verse 31. In the past, God overlooked such ignorance, but now he commands all people everywhere to repent. Now verse 31 is the reason he commands this, right? Why? 31. For he has set a day when he will judge the world with justice by the man he has appointed. He has given proof of this to all men by raising him from the dead. Do you understand what Simeon saw? Simeon saw the real end. That's why he says, I can go, I can die. But he saw that he has defeated death, which we are coming to. He has defeated death. say, I can now go in peace. But he saw the judgment of the thoughts of the hearts of men. Second Corinthians, precious people. Chapter 5, verse 10. For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, so that each one may receive what is due him for the things done while in the body, whether good or bad, including the thoughts of the heart. Hallelujah. There is honor here, right? There is also honor. When Simeon was beholding the Messiah and blessing, a woman appears, 84 years old, very old. She has been in the temple day and night. Can you imagine? She married, and that time, lesser people were marrying at 18, right? So she lived only for 7 years, and then for the rest of the time, widowed in the temple. Can you imagine? Hallelujah. When she saw that, she appeared also. And the Bible says, she began to speak also words about this Messiah. And guess what? And the Bible says, she spoke to those who were waiting for the deliverance of what? Jerusalem. Meaning she spoke to, she rebuked the sanctuary incident. For her, when Simeon came and talked about both salvation for the Gentiles, yet Simeon was talking more about the Gentiles, for her she came and rebuked those who were inside there, that he is being revealed here. What are you doing there? Because remember, this woman was 84 years old in the outer sanctuary, in the outer court. She never crossed in. Excuse me. I'm wondering, are there any widows in the church? Are there the honors of today? The Bible tells me that this widow, she was praying and fasting on a daily basis, day and night, for many years. And the Lord is looking for the widows of virtue, the widows of God, the widows of honor, the widows he can use to reveal the Messiah to the stone-hearted, to the inner sanctuary, stone-hearted. And when I look at today's widows, when your husband dies, I see most of you, after you've taken the dead body, you come back to a city, lock yourself for a week, buy a cloth, a short cloth, Cinderella, with round bubbles, round red, green, round, round like this, with round, short Cinderella. After 1 week, you wash yourself properly and smear Vaseline and wear slippers. I see the widows of this hour walking like that, short dress walking after 1 week. Where are the honors of this day? And this woman was there for all those years in the outer court, not inside. And when the Messiah came, the Lord revealed to her. Where are the women that the Lord will reveal to the Messiah? That they may go and rebuke the hard-hearted. To the gospel of Simeon, this church, he said, number one, the Holy Spirit came upon him. Meaning, how about you, right? Number two, he was promised that he would witness the coming of the Messiah. Number three, that promise came as a revelation from the Holy Spirit. Number four, he must have waited for a very, very long time. Watching and waiting is the word. Number five, Simeon was the priest to whom Jesus was brought to be blessed, not redeemed. Simeon is the one that was tipped to reveal the Messiah to the nations. That's why you see he ran out to the sanctuary and he announced, Sovereign Lord, mine eyes have now seen the promise Now dismiss your servant in peace. You have fulfilled the promise. I have seen your salvation. He revealed that this Messiah is the salvation to the nations. So he revealed the Messiah to the nations. What an awesome task. Right? What a wonderful tipping. He was tipped to be the one that would go there and reveal the Messiah that this is he. Right? The temple was always a center of worship and the place where God met his people and God dwelt with his people. The temple was the place where God, number one, always visited his people. Number two, the cloud came at worship and dwelt among his people. Number three, when the cloud came, that became the revelation of God to his people. Three things. And he said, when it was time for God the Son to be revealed to his people also, God the Son. Then it also had to happen where? In the Jerusalem temple. And he says, when it was time for God the Son to be revealed to the nations, it also happened in the temple where God used to come to visit his people, right? However, it was in the outer court. No wonder now when the cloud of God comes, it is coming in the Gentile church out in Kisumu. So, be careful. He's saying here that he had to come and dwell among his people. And ever since he entered the Jerusalem temple revealed in the outer court, from that day on he has been dwelling among his people in our hearts forever, right? Hallelujah, as Lord and King, right? When it was time for him to come to be revealed, he also had come through the Jerusalem temple where God the Father used to come and visit his people, dwell among his people, be revealed among his people. But now, ever since then, the Messiah came, and look, he has been dwelling in his temple. Hallelujah. Forever and ever. Said that when the church is taken, even the spirit is gone, right? As a woman, Mary must have not crossed past the women's court. Therefore, the meeting between Simeon and the Messiah must have taken place in the court of women, the court of Gentiles, outside the main sanctuary. We have said this before, but now formally putting it. It is hence the out court that the Lord revealed. It was in the outcourt that the Lord revealed his plans to send the Messiah as the deliverer of not only Israel, but the nations. So it is at the outer court that he revealed his plan to bring salvation to not only Israel, but even to the Gentiles. Simeon states here that having seen the Messiah, he is now ready to die and depart in peace. Implying that anyone that ever has the privilege to encounter the Messiah and behold him, his salvation is in his arms. The fear of death is erased, is eroded. For anyone that ever has the privilege of beholding the Messiah and his salvation in his arm, in his view, the fear of death is normally downward, erased. Simeon, beholding the Messiah, was actually the prefiguration, the foreshadowing of God saying that those that will be born again will be looking like this. They will look like this. So how about this church? The church of Christ of this day. Where are the Simeons of today? And the Bible says Simeon was righteous during the dispensation of darkness. He was devout. The Holy Spirit upon him. He was watching and waiting. But where are the Simeons of today? If this was the prefiguring, the foreshadowing of the salvation that he brought, then where is the church that is walking in this faithfulness?